Patty, and welcome back to the workshop. As some of you may know, the time of year, it's not quite fall or winter. It's currently soup season. And when you have soup, it's generally frowned upon to just slurp it out of the pot that it was cooked in, which is why we have something called a ladle. Now, ladles are pretty neat, and I've never made one before, but I've got this chunk of titanium right here that was given to me by my friend Michael Walker, legendary knife maker. He was actually the first one to ever use titanium in knife making. We probably won't be the first ones to make a titanium ladle, but we might be the first ones to ever forge a titanium ladle, and that's what we're gonna be doing today. We're gonna fire up the forge, throw this chunk of 1-inch round stock in there, and hopefully by the end of the day, we'll be able to use this chunk of round stock to hold and transfer soup. So titanium is a super interesting material because it's very strong, but it's also very light. It's not quite as light as aluminum, but I've got here a chunk of 1¼-inch Crew Forge V round stock. This is probably a little bit over 1 inch, and it's something that just kind of fell apart while I was forging on it. And so this chunk, as you can see, quite a bit smaller than the titanium, 5.6 ounces, and this, quite a bit longer, 5 ounces. So this chunk weighs less than this piece of steel, which is like half its size. Pretty wild. So it should be a pretty ideal soup-carrying material. It also doesn't have any metallic-y flavors or anything like that, so it's not gonna poison you probably when you're making soup or moving it around with it. It also has excellent heat transfer properties, and so you're not gonna be burning yourself on the handle when you've got some very hot soup in the bowl, so. Now, in order to get the bowl of the ladle shaped, we're gonna be using this little swage block right here. As you can tell, it's gonna be this large, round, circular area, but the fact that we're gonna be able to use this swage block is cool because the neat part of pretty much every swage block, not all of them, is that they kind of have 4 even sides, which means that these swage blocks are actually square spaces. And as we all know, the neat thing about Squarespace is that they're today's sponsor. Well, you didn't know that, but now you do. You see, Squarespace is an online website building platform that I absolutely love. Now, Squarespace is incredibly easy to use, not just if you are a professional computer programmer. You can be a regular illiterate knife maker and still be able to build a beautiful website because they have pre-laid out website designs, which means that you don't need to have the know-how to get everything sorted out from scratch. They've got you covered with everything from galleries to links to your social media to blogs to the ability to very easily sell products through the website. They make all of that incredibly simple. In fact, Michael Walker, the fellow that I got this titanium from, just built a Squarespace website. And I think he said it took a couple hours to build it, but he built an awesome website, which is cool because he has an incredible catalog of hundreds of absolutely mind-bogglingly cool knives that now there's an awesome place to be able to go online and see it, learn about him as a person, as a knife maker, learn about his work. They also have integrations where you can use point of sale systems. You can track all of your inventory even while you're out at a farmer's market or selling at a knife show or something like that. So if you guys are interested in building a Squarespace website and presenting information, sharing what you're passionate about, please go to squarespace.com/WillStelter and use code WillStelter at checkout for 10% off your first purchase of a website domain or a website. Thank you to Squarespace for sponsoring today's episode. With that, let's ladle on over to the forge. That's not a word. That's not a good way to use that. With that, let's head on over to the forge and start forging. Now that we've got the inside of the ladle bowl from the swage block cleaned out, start off by upsetting that material a little bit so that I can make sure that I have enough material for the bowl of the ladle. And so I'll get a little bit more thickness by upsetting, and then I'll draw out my handle a touch, and then hopefully be able to spread some things around to get things in the right places. Probably have to do a little bit of grinding to trim it round, and then hopefully get it shaped nice and easy in the ladle swage. Thank you.
All right, we've got the ball forged, we got the handle rough forged. Now I'm gonna turn on the power hammer and flatten this whole thing down. Since it's a ball, it should spread out pretty dang round with direct force coming down, but we'll see how it goes. Maybe we'll have to restart. Holy smokes. I forged my hammer handle off. I think that's it. It's straight, super light. Now we gotta play around with different finishes. I think I'm gonna start off by seeing if I can wire wheel it, see how that cleans it up. I think that'll be nice, because then from there, I'll probably go back and clean up a couple areas with the grinder. There's like some sharp stuff here and on the bowl. I'll clean it. Ouch. This is a titanium sliver. Ooh. Youch. Well, here we have our finished ladle. It is looking fantastic. Here's my old ladle. It looks very bad, and it is smaller than this one, and this one is cool. But right now, the fact that it's gonna work is only theory, and in order to prove that theory, I'm gonna make some pumpkin soup here at the end of October. Very fitting. I've never made a pumpkin soup before, but we're gonna start off by roasting and then pureeing some pumpkins, and then making a lovely fall winter soup from there. So let's get to it.
Well, I'll tell you guys what, that soup had absolutely no business being that delicious. That's actually the first time I think I've ever made soup, and it came out fantastic. I made chili a while back, but that didn't really count. Maybe it does. But anyhow, I started off with those sugar pumpkins, roasted them for about 45 minutes or so, scooped them out, blended that up into a nice puree. From there, I added that with some chicken stock into the pot, along with a cup of caramelized onions. I didn't call for caramelized onions, but I had a bunch of caramelized onions from last night when I was making steaks, and of course, caramelized up some onions to go with that. And I was like, you know what, that sounds pretty good. And it turns out it was good. And then I also added a clove of garlic, about a tablespoon of fresh thyme chopped up, and some salt. Let that boil. And then I threw it all into a blender after about half an hour of kind of simmering. Pureed that all together, threw it back in the pot, let it simmer for another half an hour, and then added in some nice heavy whipping cream, stirred it all together. And then I got to use this absolutely delightful titanium ladle. What a treat. It worked great. Two ladles. Two scoops, two bowls from this was like perfect amount, not too much, not too little, delightful. The curve of this handle turns out doesn't matter a whole lot, but it looks good. It kind of looks like Gandalf's pipe from The Lord of the Rings. But anyhow, I'm now full of warm soup. It was delicious, and I'm getting tired. I need to go to bed. But thank you guys so much for following along. Thank you to Squarespace for sponsoring today's episode. Thank you to our patrons for patronizing us. And with that, see you guys later. Bye-bye.